Hi, and welcome to The Pulse, your one-stop show for everything happening in St. Charles City. My name's Ed Akers, and today I'm joined by Jim Wright, Director of Public Works. You may think of Public Works as just repairing potholes, but there's so much more than meets the eye. From repairing sewer laterals to giving rides across town, Public Works works for you. So we're here with Jim Wright, Director of Public Works, and we're talking sewer lateral program.
Yeah.
Exciting stuff. We have a great sewer lateral program that I would not have even remembered until you brought that up. So it's 100% free on the water line?
It is. So the way the program works is it covers your water service line, which takes the water from your meter to your home, and that's privately held. And then it also covers the sewer lateral, which covers from your home to the city sewer main. And what that, if you ever have any issue with it, you know, a typical repair might be if your water service line breaks and you'll see water coming up out of your yard or you got low water pressure, our service specialist will come out, we'll check everything out, see if it is a leak, and if it is, then you can work through our program. The water line's covered $2,000 100% for that repair. You have your contractors work and repair that, and then it's a reimbursement.
Yeah.
The sewer lateral program, it's 90% is covered up to $7,500. And that's paid in, that money comes from a fee on your property tax. So you have $26 a year for the sewer lateral program and $10 a year for your water service line.
How many times a year are those events happening? Because, you know, being in the city here,
sure,
we do have these old clay pipes.
Yeah.
The old trees, they get in there, they crumble those pipes. The pipes are not built, the clay pipes are not really built to last a long time anyway when they were originally
right.
put in. I imagine there's a ton of events a year.
Definitely, we definitely have a lot more sewer, instances than water. I'd say sewer, it's probably 50, 60 a year that we have.
Okay.
Generally, they are in the older sections of town. They can fail for many number of reasons, the type of pipe, settlement, roots are huge on that. And then the water line, it's probably about 10, it's less.
Okay.
Those can fail due to the type of pipe or freeze thaw can affect water lines a lot. And then we also had a program where we went through and identified all the lead service lines in the city.
Oh, interesting.
And those were also covered under the program. Even though they might be functioning fine, we want to get those lead service lines out.
Now, was that a proactive outreach on the city's part to contact the people with the lead pipes?
It was proactive, but it was also a federal mandate.
Okay.
That was put out. We are years ahead of that federal mandate. The federal mandate has it like 2032.
They all need to be replaced by then.
By that time, they have to be identified and replaced or have a plan to replace. But we've had a policy since the 40s that have outlawed lead service lines. So we really didn't have a whole lot, but we did have a handful, and a lot of those have been replaced.
Nice. Mm-hmm. And what's the best way? I always find, going back to my background in insurance, you mentioned where coverage begins and ends for the city,
right,
where it begins and ends for the homeowner. And,
sure,
and typically what I've told people is anything under your home is your responsibility. Once it leaves your home and goes into your front yard, you know, you need to check with your city, with your municipality.
Yeah.
But the insurance covers everything inside the home. What I've heard from people is, and not in St. Charles City, but how do they find out this information? If they do have a pipe burst or if they're buying a home and they need the sewer lateral repaired,
right,
what's the best way for them to get in touch with you?
Well, they can always call Public Works, and we also have a lot of information on our website. But in the city of St. Charles, the way it works on who's responsible, the city owns the water main that goes down the road. We own the meter that's in the meter pit, and that's typically in the curb line somewhere. And then any water line from the meter to the home is private and the responsibility of the property owner.
Okay.
And on the sewer side, it's anything from the home to the main. So sometimes that main can be in the middle of the road. And so the property owner will be responsible for that lateral going out into the road.
Always best to call, it seems like.
Definitely best to call. Yeah. You know, and we can direct somebody to the best, you know, help that we have. We have an employee that's all they do is the insurance program.
Oh, nice.
He does a really good job of, you know, working with property owners. You know, it's at a time that there's a lot of stress for that homeowner.
Sure.
Going through it, you know, not knowing what to do. And his name's Dustin. Dustin does a really good job of kind of working with those property owners, putting them at ease, and then getting walking them through that process.
Yeah. Yeah. A lot of times those events don't happen or people don't realize them until they're buying or selling a home.
Right.
Right. Because they're getting that sewer lateral inspection. And then, yeah, you're talking about adding to the stress of moving and closing and all these things. Is it necessary to get that sewer lateral inspection incrementally throughout the years, or is it only something you should do when buying or selling a home?
You know, you'll usually have some indications that there's something going on, right? If you're getting some backups in your basement, it could be a sign of a sewer lateral collapse. If your toilets aren't flushing right, it could be an issue of some type of blockage. So you'll usually see some signs that something's not working right.
Yeah.
And that's when you should call the city. On the water side, if you have low water pressure, that could, you know, that means you might have a leak in your service line. If you're seeing water bubbling up out of your yard where it isn't normally.
That's a definite, yeah.
So that could be a sign as well. And,
yeah.
And so you usually they'll see something that's not right and then they'll call.
Makes sense.
Yep.
Well, Jim, we could talk about sewer lateral for days.
We could.
Apparently, but
it's very exciting.
We want to get to know you. There is a lot of information there to unpack, honestly.
Yeah.
We want to get to know you, Jim.
How, sure.
We were talking off camera. You were with MoDOT for 14 years, you said?
Yeah.
And
yeah.
And transitioned into the city of St. Charles after that?
Yeah, I started my career, first job out of college was Missouri Department of Transportation. That was in 2003. I went to school here in Missouri at University of Missouri Science and Technology. They've changed the name since.
We just called it Rolla.
Yeah, it's University of Missouri Rolla
is where, what it is now.
No, it's where that's what it was.
Okay.
Now it's the Missouri University of Science and Technology.
MUST.
MST. I guess MST is what
okay.
it goes by.
MST, yeah. I gotcha.
And that's studied civil engineering and started in MoDOT on the construction side, building bridges and highways, and it's, you know, enjoyed that part of my career. When I left MoDOT, I was area engineer for St. Charles County, working with a lot of municipalities to kind of meet their needs as that kind of coincided with MoDOT's needs and the city's needs. And then in 2017, I came to the city of St. Charles as Director of Public Works.
What drew you to that? Was it the experience working with the city, working with the county?
Right. Yeah, a lot of that. You know, having worked with the city at my role at MoDOT, I saw kind of what the city of St. Charles did and the way it functioned and the processes and systems it had set up. And it's a high functioning organization. And it was an organization that I really kind of saw myself, you know, fitting well in there. It's been a great decision.
And you've been with the city how long now?
So I was with the city from 2017 to 2021. In 2021, we actually went to Atlanta, me and my wife. My wife had a job opportunity for a promotion in Atlanta. And it was a tough decision.
Sure.
And we spent the last 3 years there. We enjoyed it, but you know, circumstances made it to where we came back, and the city was gracious enough to have me back in the same role. And so I started back up in January of this year.
Okay, I think that says a lot about not only you, but the city, that you're a person that they would want back, and that it's a place that you would want to come back to.
It's like, you know, slipping on an old pair of pants that fit really well.
There
right?
you go.
You know, it was an interesting position because, you know, in the 3 years I was gone, a lot of the initiatives that we had started, you kind of see the fruit, you know, the outcomes of and how it's progressed. But there's still a lot of the same challenges, right?
Sure.
from when we were there in 17 and now, you know, we still have a lot of work to do, and you know, there's never enough resources, and so prioritizing those is very important.
And tell me about public works. There's a lot that fits under that umbrella.
Yeah.
But I think just as a layperson, we think of the roads and kind of facilities like that, but I know there's a lot more to it.
Yeah, yeah, we have three main divisions. We have the street division, the utilities division, and the facilities division. On the street side, it's everything from maintaining our roads, our sidewalks, our signals, our lights, street signs. On the utility division, we have a water side and a sewer side. On the water side, we operate a water treatment plant on Elm Point Industrial Drive that is capable of producing 6 million gallons a day. And then we have that distribution system that takes the water from that plant into all the homes. On the sewer side, we have two wastewater treatment plants, one on the Missouri River and one on the Mississippi River. And then that full collection system that takes the sewage from the homes to those plants. And so that's, you know, I say that really quick, but there's a lot that's involved in that.
I was going to say, you are responsible for a right. lot. How many people on your team? I mean, with those, across those three different divisions?
We have 95 positions.
I was going to guess way more than
for
that.
For that, yeah. And so we
that's very efficient.
Yeah, we do a lot with what we're given. You know, in addition to that water and utility side, the facility side, we have responsible for 19 overall facilities, including City Hall, the Foundry Arts Center, the Public Works Facility, PD, Police Station, and the fire stations. And then we have support facilities such as our fleet mechanics. We have a full garage at Public Works where we have a team of five mechanics that take care of all of our operating equipment, which is no easy task, right? It's a very wide range of equipment. You know, it can go from a passenger car to a dump truck to a large excavator, street sweeper, it can be anything. And so those guys really have to know, you know, their skill sets have to be really broad to take care of our stuff. And then we also operate a transit system. We have a fleet of five buses and drivers that operate an on-demand system. And so anybody within the city for 50 cents can call and schedule a ride door-to-door anytime between 9 and 3 or 9 and 4.
Tell me more about that. I have no idea.
Yeah. So the history of that program, it started out called the Golden Rod, the Golden Age Express, I think.
Okay.
It was mainly a senior
citizens.
Yeah, it was mainly a senior service transit or provider. Then they transitioned to a full fixed route system. So we had four routes that had fixed routes all over the city. When COVID hit, we, you know, just like a lot of other transit providers, we backed off and said, hey, what are we going to do here? And we transitioned to an on-demand system where people would call, schedule a ride. They could, you know, get picked up at their home and go to a doctor's appointment or the grocery store, and then schedule a ride back for 50 cents.
Wow. Do they take two quarters when you, I mean, how do you pay the 50 cents?
It is cash only.
Okay.
and what I like to say about this program is the service we provide with the resources that we put in it is tremendous. You know,
I would imagine so, yeah.
Our budget, I think, is $200,000 for this system, and we were able to provide that on-demand system.
How frequently is this used, do you think?
It's a very popular program.
Okay.
We have, we're capable, we run fairly full most of the day. You know, our biggest challenge right now is drivers. Getting those, you know, it's a part-time position, and finding drivers is very challenging right now.
I imagine so. You see that even just driving down the road past schools where they need drivers.
Mm-hmm.
Wow, that is crazy. I had no idea. Now, that's not the same thing as the St. Charles Area Transit buses. Is that what those are?
Yeah, that's what that is.
Okay.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So they, instead of running a route now, it's on demand. And so you may have to wait a little longer if there's people, you may not go directly to your.
Right. We try to go door to door as much as we can.
Okay.
We tell people to give us half hour on that pickup or drop off window. Mm. And, you know, because if we have to go from one side of the city to the other and then back, we do our best to schedule those in a way that kind of just, you know, minimizes that disruption.
And this is available to any resident in the city.
Yeah, any resident in the city.
I think that's our tip or trick. I wonder how many people know about that.
Yeah, we promote it as much as we can. You know, our primary customers are elderly and, you know, some, you know, people who have ADA requirements.
Sure.
Yeah.
Yeah, makes sense. Okay, tell me, I want to know a little bit more about you. What sure. do you like to do for fun? What's your favorite thing to do in the city, whether that's a place to go or an activity, yeah. a celebration?
Yeah, well, you know, so when, I guess you don't know what you really like until you're gone. So right, we had those okay. 3 years out in Georgia. And when, you know, the things that you really miss is, it's just, you don't realize how the gem that Main Street is.
Yeah.
Not a lot of cities that I've seen have that, you know, that old historical feel, the buildings, the care that's put into it. It really is kind of a unique thing. But what I really missed, the first thing I did when I came back was there's a place on at 5th and Clark called Gimme Golf.
Oh yeah,
it's a little golf simulator. Yep. It's kind of a clubhouse feel, more of a you know, everybody knows everybody type thing. And so I went back and I joined there the first thing, because I do like to golf. And so that was really fun, just kind of getting back into, you know, the Gimme Golf clubhouse.
Yeah, that's fun. Yeah. I've been in there a few times. I think they're expanding or trying to put yeah. maybe some more stuff, a restaurant or maybe a brewery in there or something.
Yeah.
But that's a very fun place. So when you're not at working, we can catch you swinging the clubs at Gimme Golf or another driving range possibly?
Yeah, maybe.
Okay.
Yeah.
Have you played anything? Like what's the most fun course you've played? Have you gotten to travel and play any dream courses or anything?
Last year I was at a conference in San Diego and I was able to play Torrey Pines.
Oh, cool.
And so that was probably the coolest course that I've played.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I actually was able to play Torrey Pines as well.
Yeah.
When I was a Farmers Insurance agent, the Farmers Open is there.
Oh, yeah.
And I qualified for it. It's a sales trip, but the second year I qualified for it, they called me and said, hey, you're the only agent from Missouri that qualified. Do you yeah. want to play in the Pro-Am?
Oh.
And I was like, oh, I need to start taking lessons. And so actually, this was before his hot run like a year ago, but I got to play with Lucas Glover.
Okay.
So walked 18 with Lucas. And
well, that is really cool.
It was very neat, something that obviously like a once-in-a-lifetime experience, but yeah, what a beautiful course and
it
just
was really nice.
A beautiful place to be.
Yeah.
That's fun. Well, tell me, what's the easiest way for someone to get in touch with you or your department if they have a service, if they need something?
Sure.
How do they do that?
So, you know, we have, obviously, if you need information, we have a ton of information on our website. You can always call us. But if you have an issue, the best thing to do is, it's called Report a Concern. This is an online tool that you can access through our website. And it's as simple as saying, hey, I have a problem. This is what my problem is. This is where it's located. And it's going to go, it's going to direct that to the right department, right? Whether it's water or sewer or streets or even outside of public works. If it's community development or police related, they'll get those as well. And what that does is it really streamlines that process. You know, it doesn't have to go through three different people and say, you know, if you call the water department and it's sewer, then, you know, you're getting passed. We don't want to pass people around to three or four different people.
Sure.
We want to get the issue taken care of as soon as we can. And so when you use report a concern, it's going to go straight to the supervisor that is responsible for that, you know, whatever the concern is. So if it's a pothole, it's going to go straight to our street supervisor so they can get that prioritized and added to their work orders. If it's a stormwater issue where it's a, you know, clogged up drain, it's going to go straight to our sewer department and, you know, it'll go straight to their work orders. You know, if it's an emergency, the best thing to do is call them.
And what is that website and phone number?
So the website is www.stcharlescitymo.gov, and that's where you'll have links to Public Works and all the information we talked about, as well as report a concern. And then to call us, our main line at Public Works is 636-949-3363. Yeah.
Gotcha. Mm-hmm. Well, Jim, thanks for joining me. It sounds like you're a busy man. I'm not sure how you carved out the 25 minutes for us, but I'm glad you did. And the city of St. Charles is glad to have you and lucky to have you.
All right. I appreciate it.
Thanks.
Thank
you, Ed. Wow. Public Works does a lot. I had no idea the actual scope of their department and everything they do for the city and its residents until I had that interview. There's a ton of information there, and I encourage you to go to our website at stcharlescitymo.gov/departments/publicworks for more information or to report a concern. We'll also link that in the show notes. And here's your City Council recap. City Council unanimously passed Bill number 13581, which continues the moratorium on short-term rental properties in the city through July 25th, 2025. There are currently around 110 short-term rentals in the city, which includes residential, commercial, and the guest houses that have been grandfathered in. The capacity for short-term rentals in the city is 160 based on our population and the current ordinance. 4th of July is right around the corner, and for an update on Riverfest, let's throw it to Ryan Cooper.
America's birthday is coming up, and we want you to be in St. Charles for Riverfest. Don't miss out on July 4th and 5th in Frontier Park. Fireworks, bam, we got them. Both nights at 9:20 p.m. Can't miss bands, we got them. Food on a stick, we got that too. And who doesn't love a parade? 10 a.m. on July 4th through Frenchtown and down historic Main Street. Plus, carnival rides and games from Fountain City Amusements, a kids area, and a lot more. Visit us today at stcharlescitymo.gov/riverfest for all the can't miss details.
Thanks for checking out this episode of The Pulse. Make sure you hit that subscribe button in the lower left-hand corner and then hit the bell that comes up so you'll have the latest episodes delivered right to you. I'm Ed Akers, and I'll see you in the city.